witnessing on Sunday and watching the graduating seniors share their faith stories, thinking that someday I would get to be one of those seniors that spoke. But the other day when I sat down to write what I wanted to say up here, I was totally stumped. You'd think that if I'd known I wanted to do this since I was a kid, I would have a good idea of what I wanted to share, but apparently not. How was I to put into words what North Church has meant to me over all these years? My life here dates back to before I can remember. When I was about 4 months old, I was baptized in this sanctuary by my grandfather and Reverend Hamilton. At the time, I had no understanding of what was happening, but looking back now, I realize that it truly was the beginning, sort of like an induction into my new North Church family. From then on, my parents weren't the only ones looking out for me and teaching me values. I also had an entire faith community committed to helping me grow up to be the best Christian I could be. Over the years, there have been Sunday school teachers, Vacation Bible School volunteers, alternative worship leaders, choir directors, and so many others who have shaped me. It's impossible to thank everyone who has been a part of this process, but I do hope you all know that what North does to develop its phenomenal children's and youth ministry is a worthwhile dedication of our prayers, presence, gifts, and service. The reason this faith story was so much more difficult to write than I expected was because I never realized how much I have become a part of North Church and how much North has become a part of me. Some of my friends at school have often looked at me with puzzled expressions when I said I was going down to church, and they would reply, "But it's not Sunday, why?" I'd have to explain to them that it wasn't just about going to service on Sunday morning. I had other reasons to come here. Church, meetings, retreats, service projects, those kind of things. And Sunday morning worship services are certainly a beautiful and important part of this place. But North's influence reaches far beyond that hour of my Sunday morning. For example, ASP and middle school mission projects have given me a love for service and volunteering that will stay with me the rest of my life. I guess if I were to define one moment that illustrated what this place has taught me, I would identify the evening of my 16th birthday. I was spending 2 weeks of my summer at the Christian Formation Camp at Duke Divinity School. It helps to have friends with connections like Kevin and Lisa. Each evening, we would split into small discussion groups and reflect on the day's lectures, workshops, and worship services. That day, something that had gone on sparked a conversation in our small group that evolved into what was essentially a very judgmental talk about who's going to heaven and who's not, and a few other technicalities. As you can imagine, the discussion was a bit heated, especially because the group included students from a variety of religious backgrounds. I didn't really want to get involved in the debate, but eventually I did, and I asked my peers in that group to stop and consider this idea for just a moment. What if what we were debating didn't matter? What if the little details weren't that important? Maybe church was about looking at the example Jesus gave us and trying to model that unconditional love to everyone we meet. Now I realize that this has been the most important thing I've learned about faith from North. Faith isn't about rules and restrictions, and it isn't about repentance and fearing God. Faith is about loving our neighbors. I know that no matter what comes next in my life, North will always be a community of unconditional love and acceptance.